Hi, I'm Ron Brown. Join me as I travel across the world to peek over the shoulders of the most talented, most dedicated, and most respected chefs on the planet as we meet the chefs of the great hotels of the world.
Berwick Street Market behind me is just a stone's throw from the Savoy Hotel on the Strand here in London. I'm on my way to meet executive chef Marcus-Wareing and chef de cuisine Josh-Emmet. Why don't you join me?
The Savoy Theatre, which opened in 1881, was built by Richard Doyley Cart on the site of the old Savoy Palace as a showcase for the operas of Gilbert and Sullivan. It was the first public building in the world to be lit entirely by electricity. The Savoy Hotel was later opened by Doyley Cart in 1889. It was and remains one of London's most prestigious and opulent hotels, with 230 rooms. First manager Cesar Ritz later became the founder of the Ritz Hotel. The Savoy has long been famous for its inventive chefs. Its kitchen saw the invention of Pêche Melba, created in honour of Dame Nellie Melba by the legendary French chef Auguste Escoffier. Today, the Savoy Grill is managed by a company operated by infamous celebrity chef Gordon Ramsay and his partner Marcus-Wareing. I spoke to Marcus in the dining room about the changes they've introduced.
Savoy, I felt when I arrived, was the grill room was slightly dated, a little bit ancient in its approach to its customers and its customer service. Excuse me, and just needed to bring in into the modern world, pretty much like what John did in the early days. When he had the idea of bringing the likes of Gordon and myself into hotels.
As anyone who has ever seen Gordon Ramsay on the telly knows, Gordon and Marcus run a tight ship. Their young kitchen brigade members are trained in the Ramsay School of Hard Knocks, and there is a strong take-no-prisoners approach to their operations. But these chefs are not afraid to put it on display. One of the innovations at the Savoy is the chef's table, a glass bubble dining area inside the kitchen. But how popular was it with customers, I wondered?
Huge. Huge. Absolutely huge. People are so much more interested in cuisine. And because it is the unknown, and people have no idea or concept of what a kitchen, how a kitchen runs, sometimes you get your guests whose noses are glued to the window just looking at what's going on. Really, really do.
Back in the kitchen, it was time to look in on the next dish, based on that popular ingredient, pork belly. The use of sous vide technology, which expels air from the storage bag under pressure, hermetically seals it and then uses slow cooking in water at temperatures as low as 65 degrees for many hours, has become the method of choice at the Savoy Grill to achieve the best of both worlds. Both slow cooking and fast service are facilitated by the humble plastic bag. All that's left, when a customer places the order, is to warm and assemble the other ingredients.
Simon and his team, Josh and his team, won a Michelin-Star within 7 months of this restaurant opening, something that this restaurant has never, ever done. So they, myself, the team and the company are incredibly proud of that fact. And that shows that we are doing something right. And every day this restaurant's got bums on seats, but it also shows that the restaurant is doing the right thing. For me, my ultimate goal as a chef is to win 3 Michelin-Stars. We have the Michelin Guide in Europe, and that is the fundamental most important thing for me. But I do get a huge kick out of not only striving for that goal, but also being part of a very exciting group with Gordon, being his partner, is very, very inspiring for me. There's more to this job than just sort of running restaurants. There's so much more to it. So cookery is my mainstream. Michelin stars are my second, and third is running the business. You know, I'm very proud of being a chef. I'm very proud of being a restaurateur. It's what I live in these whites, and it is my life. Take them away from me, and I'm just Joe Bloggs.